Benzene was first discovered by the great Michael Faraday, and at that time, chemists could figure out the molecular formulas of compounds, but they didn't know the exact dot structures. And so chemists knew that benzene contained 6 carbons and 6 hydrogens, but they weren't sure exactly how those atoms were connected. And so there were several different proposals for structures for benzene, and the winning structure was proposed by Auguste Kekulé, who said that benzene contains 6 carbons in a ring, and then you have alternating single and double bonds in that ring. And the story goes that Kekulé came up with this dot structure when he had a dream, and he saw some snakes bite each other's tails, and the snakes then whirled around in a circle, and that gave Kekulé the idea for the ring. So this is one possible dot structure for benzene, but I didn't have to draw my double bonds in this place. I can actually show a resonance structure for benzene, right? I could take these electrons, move them over here, push these electrons over here, and then these electrons would be over here. And so a resonance structure for benzene, right? I could have my pi electrons over here, and over here. So either one of these Kekulé structures is an acceptable dot structure for benzene. And remember, in reality, since these are resonance structures, the actual molecule is more of a hybrid of these two molecules. And with that in mind, sometimes chemists will prefer to represent benzene with the 6 carbons in a ring and with a circle here in the center to represent the delocalization of those pi electrons. And so maybe this is the lazy way to represent benzene. And this is called a Robinson circle, after the great synthetic organic chemist Sir Robert Robinson. And so sometimes the Robinson circle is a useful way to represent benzene, and sometimes a Kekulé structure is over here on the left. And you would use a Kekulé structure if you're trying to show the mechanism of reactions that benzene does. All right, let's look at how to name derivatives of benzene. So here we have benzene with a methyl group coming off of it. And so you could just call this molecule methyl benzene. So that's one possible name for it. But most people don't call it methyl benzene. It's called toluene. So it's such a common molecule in organic chemistry that toluene is an acceptable IUPAC name. And in this example, we have an alkyl substituent that has only one carbon, right? This methyl group has only one carbon versus the 6 in the benzene ring. Well, what happened if your alkyl group had more carbons than your benzene ring, which is the situation over here on the right? So if we count up how many carbons we have a total of 7 carbons. And so in this case, we're actually going to name this as an alkane and name the benzene ring as a substituent coming off of our alkane. So a 7-carbon alkane would be called heptane, so I can go ahead and write heptane here. And then I have a benzene ring coming off of carbon 4, and when you're naming a benzene ring as a substituent, so it'd be C6H5, substituent coming off of my ring here, we call it a phenyl group. So I have a phenyl group coming off of carbon 4, so this would be 4-phenylheptane as the IUPAC name for this molecule. Let's look at some other examples where we see benzene with one group on the ring. And these are all very famous monosubstituted benzenes. And because they are so famous, their common name is acceptable in IUPAC nomenclature. Right, so a benzene ring with an OH group on it is called phenol, and we can use that when we're naming molecules. Benzaldehyde, right, would be an aldehyde coming off of a benzene ring, and benzaldehyde is of course famous for having the smell of almonds. It's a really, really wonderful smell, which is also why you'll hear some of these molecules referred to as aromatic compounds, and it originally is because of the smell, and we're going to see in future videos what aromatic means in a chemistry sense. Over here we have benzoic acid, right, a carboxylic acid functional group coming off of our benzene ring here like that. And so here I have 7 of the most famous and most common monosubstituted benzene derivatives. And so these are molecules that most professors will have you memorize, because you can use these names when you're trying to name more complicated benzene derivatives. So commit these to memory. All right, let's look at some disubstituted benzene derivatives, right? So this molecule over here on the left has 2 methyl groups coming off of the benzene ring. And so this first molecule has a methyl group coming off of carbon 1 and coming off of carbon 2. So we could call this 1,2-dimethyl benzene. That would be an acceptable IUPAC name. But whenever you have a benzene ring with 2 methyl groups on it, that's called, the common name for that is xylene. And so if we wanted to call this molecule xylene, All right. Technically, all three of these molecules will be xylene. They're all benzene ring with two methyl groups coming off of it, and so we have to distinguish these xylenes from each other. And so when you have two groups that are right next to each other on a benzene ring, in this case, my methyl groups, right? My methyl groups are right next to each other on my benzene ring. We say that relationship is ortho, right? So I could call this molecule ortho xylene, and that would be another acceptable name. And sometimes you'll just see an O there, so you call it O-xylene, and that's fine too. We go over here to this molecule. This is also xylene, but we can see the methyl groups are in slightly different positions. Right now we would have 1,3-dimethylbenzene. So 1,3-dimethylbenzene would be an acceptable name for this molecule. And when you have two groups that are a carbon away from each other, right? So this relationship is said to be meta in organic chemistry. So you could call this meta. Let me take off that M here, so I'm running out of room here. You could call this meta xylene. Right, so this is metaxylene, or just M-xylene. And then finally, another xylene molecule. This time, our two methyl groups would be at carbons 1 and 4. So you'd call this 1,4-dimethylbenzene. So you call, let me go ahead and write that. And 1,4-dimethylbenzene would be one IUPAC name for it. But again, most people would call this would name this as a xylene derivative. So it's a xylene derivative. This time my two groups are opposite each other, right? So they're opposite each other on the ring, and we call this relationship para in organic chemistry. So you could say it's para-xylene or also p-xylene. Let's look at some more examples of disubstituted benzene rings. And so here we go. We're actually going to use the monosubstituted derivatives that we talked about above. So if I look at this molecule over here on the left, I can see that there is this is the phenol portion of the molecule. All right, so I can go ahead and say that this is phenol. And then in terms of identifying the bromine, I have two options here. I could use a number. I could say, okay, that bromine is at carbon 4, so I could call this 4-bromophenol, and that's an acceptable IUPAC name. Or I could use the OMP system that we talked about above. And when you have two groups that are opposite on the ring, right, we call that para, right? So I could also call this molecule para bromophenol, right? So para-bromophenol, and that's an acceptable name as well. Or I could even shorten it to p-bromophenol. All right, let's do this disubstituted benzene ring over here. And if I look at it, right, I can see that is benzoic acid. That's one of the ones that we memorized above. So I can go ahead and write the parent name as being benzoic acid right here. And I now have to identify my substituent coming off of my benzene ring. Okay, so benzoic acid would make this carbon 1, and then my substituent is coming off of carbon 3, and my substituent is a nitro group. Right, so I could call this 3-nitro benzoic acid, or I could say that the relationship between those two things coming off my benzene ring would be meta. Right, so I could call this meta nitro benzoic acid. So let me see if I have room here. So meta nitro benzoic acid. Or I could just say M nitro benzoic acid. So all of those would be correct IUPAC names. Let's look at polysubstituted benzene derivatives now. And so these are actually two of the more famous examples that we could do. Once again, we're going to try to find a monosubstituted parent name here. And if I look, I can see that right here. This would be benzaldehyde. And so usually aldehydes have precedence over alcohols. And so that's why we're going to name this as a benzaldehyde derivative. So I'm going to go ahead and, let's see, just to make sure I have enough room, I'm going to start naming it by saying the parent name is benzaldehyde right here. And since the aldehyde gets precedence, this would get a carbon 1. We want to give the lowest number possible to our substituents coming off my ring. So I'm going to go this way. And I can see that I have a group coming off of carbon 3, right? And it's an ether group. So we talked about how to name ethers as substituents. This would be a methoxy substituent. So this would be coming off of carbon 3. So I'm going to write 3-methoxy like that. All right, and then I go over here to carbon 4, and I can see I have an OH group. And if I'm naming OH an alcohol as a substituent, I would call this a hydroxy or a hydroxyl group. And I'm going to say that this is a hydroxy group at carbon 4. So 4 hydroxy, 3-methoxy, benzaldehyde would be the IUPAC name for this molecule. This molecule is better known as vanillin. All right, so the smell of vanilla, it's probably my favorite smell, and so I really enjoy doing labs that involve the vanillin molecule. All right, let's do one more, another extremely famous example. I can see that if I'm trying to find a monosubstituted benzene derivative, that would be toluene right here. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and put toluene as my parent name. And that would make this carbon 1. The methyl group would become carbon 1. So I go ahead and number to give the lowest number possible. And I can see that I have 3 nitro substituents located at 2, 4, and 6. So to finish my IUPAC name, it'd be 2, 4, 6. I have 3 nitro, so that'd be tri as my prefix. So tri nitro toluene. And so this is also a very famous molecule. It's not normally called 2,4,6 trinitro toluene. Most people in the general public would, of course, know this as TNT, right? So the famous explosive. So this would be TNT. And we just named it, of course, the name comes from the nomenclature for polysubstituted benzene derivatives. All right, so hopefully this video just shows you an introduction as to how to name molecules with benzene in them.